Chief, I'd like to meet our new photographer, Drew Davidson. Drew, this is our editor-in-chief, Chief Groner.
Say, you're not an evil genius, are you?
No, sir, it's just an alliteration.
Bless you, please look down.
Likewise, Senator Groner.
Call me Chief.
Boss, I mean Chief.
What is it, kid?
Could you maybe let go of my hand?
Store me any time in the back, kid. That's a nice trick around there, but it's something you should know.
What is it, boss? I mean Chief.
That's not my hand.
That was a good one, Chief. I gotta hand it to you.
You had to hand it to me? I had to hand it to Drew.
Anyway, two of the boys got for the cornflakes and one for the Rice Krispies.
And the moral of the story is that two out of three boys got for cornflakes and Rice Krispies.
Not funny.
Of course it's not funny. It's a shaggy dog story. It's funny because it's not funny.
I get it.
Alright, time to get my guns. Show me what you got.
Now I see why we call the boss Chief Brother.
I've been working about the new law on undertakers.
No regulations face stiff opposition.
I got one first hand experience. My mother used to spend hours driving through tunnels under common mountains to take the chances off of practice.
Mom suffered from carpool tunnel syndrome.
And I also heard the mayor and his assistant talk about 4 foot psychic to escape a mental institution.
Small, medium, at large.
I've recently discovered that Muhammad got himself from severe foot calluses, osteoporosis, and bad breath.
Let me think for a minute. Oh, I got it. Supercalifragilistic plagiocalitosis.
Now you see why the papers call it the Daily Groner.
Every one of my headlines is
a groner.
Kid, you and Packet don't have to laugh right now. Full coverage of the opening night of the comedy festival.
Come on, kid. If you haven't been to the
library
yet, you're in for an experience.
Go see my slapstick's over, will you?
Effective immediately.
That wasn't unanimous. Miss Lincoln couldn't even help ourselves.
What's the situation in the streets, Commissioner Jordan?
Right, issue 38.
The
lawyer
is
coming. Everybody
just
building
on a new philosophy. I just pulled up this name. What happened to everyone's sense of humor?
This morning. It's pretty clear what happened.
It is.
You folks don't get average, Chief. Ever read the Daily Planet?
No.
This sort of thing happens all the time in Metropolis. In Gotham City, too.
What sort of thing?
Look, who stands to benefit from having common people rendered humorless?
Laugh at who?
You've been making an awful lot of money selling trench coats and philosophy books.
Plus, he's an evil genius. He never really knows.
Look, you've got a evil genius who stands to benefit from having Arnigo rendered humorless. He shows up in the library just before PG Grubman. He releases a stray gas in the room, and the next thing you know, everyone has lost their sense of humor. You do the math.
I was really very good at math.
But the examiner obviously released the poison gas that deactivates his sense of humor.
But how can you be sure?
You keep asking that. Listen, I was moving around what existential philosophy and foreign this morning.
They read Fields and Kierkegaard,
and I found this. This!
For sale. Remove people's sense of humor in your spare time. Seek fibers, anti-life, gases, an odorless formula that will render even the most fun-loving person humorless. Rid the world of laughter, merriment, and joy with Stick Farmer's anti-laughing gas. Special discounts for evil geniuses.
So, Vlad, the X-Hero thinks he can control Comedy Bill, huh?
You mean Harrisburg?
We've got to do something.
Arrest him. Throw the book at him.
I can't throw the book at him. There's no rule in the book against being an evil genius. Besides, even if I arrested him, we still have no sense of
humor. True. You said things like this happen all the time in Metropolis and down in the city. What do they do?
They generally call your local superheroes.
They're what?
Superheroes. You know,
Batman, Superman. Oh, excellent. We'll just call an armor
superheroes. There's just one problem with that, Mayor.
What's that?
We don't have any superheroes.
Everybody has superheroes.
Well, Seersburg doesn't.
But superheroes are just regular people with strange talents. Doesn't anyone in this town have a strange talent or powers?
Moa currently can fall down. He's a combo of his impressions.
And stand-up can make a joke out of anything.
Great. I'll go to the left right now and tell them that you're the new superhero of the Comedy Bill.
Sure hope Drew's right.
We've got to go, Your Honor. We'll be late to the opening of the philosophical gift shop.
Oh, I want to get one of those socks. It's not like
hemlock. Pat, you better make two headlines. Superhero Save Condigo and Sears Bird Sinks into Economic Depression.
But neither of those is a grower.
Don't I know it.